In this week's highlights, sugar producers are worried about souring trade relations, the oil market digests the impact of last week's OPEC Plus meeting, and commodity traders eye rising water levels on the Rhine. But first, energy markets will be watching the outcome of this Tuesday's vote on UK Prime Minister Theresa May's EU withdrawal agreement. For power, gas and carbon markets, extended uncertainty flowing from this week's vote would maintain pressure on the pound against dollar or euro-denominated fuels, as well as emission allowances, which are denominated in euros. The UK Parliament is broadly expected to reject May's deal with the EU in its current form. UK consumer price inflation rose after the referendum vote to leave the EU and has been above 2.2% since early 2017, with rising fuel prices playing a major role. This is before factoring the impact of a no-deal exit, which would cause problems for the Northern Irish power market, which relies on the Republic of Ireland for imports. Meanwhile, should Parliament approve the deal, it could spur a carbon price rally. This is because it would activate an informal transition deal, which would mean the UK staying in the emission trading scheme until the end of 2020. That would maintain demand for carbon allowances from UK emitters. On the other hand, if the deal is voted down, it raises the possibility of the UK crashing out of the EU without a deal. And this is causing concern among the remaining EU member states that traditionally export sugar to the UK, mainly France, but also the Netherlands and Belgium. The UK is a net importer of sugar. EU sugar exporters are hoping for a free trade arrangement between the EU and the UK. In the event of a hard Brexit, it won't be possible to offset the sugar losses by exporting the sweetener in form of confectionery. That brings us to our social media question this week. What impact do you think the Brexit deal vote will have on commodity markets? Tweet us your thoughts with the hashtag PlattsMM. Talking of tough negotiations, the oil market will be weighing up the aftermath of last week's OPEC non-OPEC production pact, looking for market direction. The International Energy Agency, which largely represents oil-consuming countries, will give its assessment of OPEC and its allies' agreement to cut 1.2 million barrels a day of production in its monthly oil market report on Thursday. The agency's figures on global oil demand and any revision to recent low-key estimates will be particularly closely watched. And on Wednesday, OPEC will publish its own monthly oil market report. Once oil and oil products have been produced, they have to be transported. Low Rhine water levels have hampered logistics, not only for oil products, but for a range of commodities. Now rainfall is easing the situation. As you can see, water levels have now risen from near record lows at the end of November to above 150 centimeters at Key Choke Point Carb. This is seen as a critical level for loading barges comfortably. Barge rates have started falling from exceptionally high levels. The easing Rhine situation is also expected to free up rail and trucks for ethanol and biodiesel, as well as biodiesel feedstock rapeseed to be transported from inland Europe to the ports. Prices of these commodities have rallied as a result of the transport logjam, and market participants expect them to fall back as the situation normalizes. However, the situation could still be problematic for petrochemical markets, as they face competition for barges from LPG and fuel oil. This, combined with reduced run rates for aromatics and olefins, could result in an unseasonal run-up in prices as stocks drop. As barges resume connecting products with consumers, another link will be in the news. Testing starts this week on 1 gigawatt NEMO subsea cable between the UK and Belgium. Full operation is due during the first quarter of 2019. The interconnector is sorely needed, as only two of Belgium's seven reactors are operating at present. And finally, the European steel industry will be eyeing the UN Climate Change Conference as it goes into its second week in the Polish city of Katowice. There, attention will focus on how Europe's steel and metal sectors are shaping up in the climate change stakes after a sharp increase in emissions in 2018. European Steelmakers Association, EUFER, points to the difficulties in implementing high-cost, low-carbon steelmaking in a global industry without a level playing field. It stresses the EU already imports over 26 million metric tons of steel a year from countries without comparable climate policies. Thanks for kicking off your Monday with us, and have a great week ahead.